This is title holder Cindy Johnson of Chicago, Illinois. In her title is the word pulchritudinous. We had to look it up, but all you have to do is stay tuned for What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's panel, Soupy Sale, Anita Gillette, Ed Gordon, Arlene Francis, and the host of What's My Line, Larry White.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hi there.
My goodness, Anita, I think that's the first time you wore a dress.
It's true. I haven't worn a dress for a long time. I took it out of the trunk.
Well, it's a thrill to find out that something happens between your ankle bone and your jaw.
I beg your pardon.
Well, you can see your legs for the first time is what I mean.
Yeah.
And don't keep those from us anymore.
That's right.
Thank
now, would our first challenger enter and sign in, please? Cindy Johnson. Where are you from?
I'm from Chicago, Illinois.
That's a good place. Panel, Cindy Johnson is the 15th young lady to bear an illustrious title. We will show the audience just what her title is. And let's begin the questioning with Soupy Sale.
Thank you. Cindy, this title, you've won a title, right?
Yes, I have.
Does it have anything to do with anything that's living?
Yes.
Well, she is, but the title is not. One down, nine to go, Anita.
Nothing that's living. Maybe rule out that it has anything to do with food.
No.
No, you may not.
I knew it every time I asked that question.
Two down and eight to go, Henry.
Is there a word, a royal word in your title?
A royal word? No.
No royal. How did you mean royal?
Like queen of.
Yes. Three down and seven to go, Marlene.
So it has something to do with food. Is it,
You would think there would be, Henry, but in this case there isn't. So you got it on a technicality, actually.
Okay.
Arlene?
Is it a food that one might enjoy at mealtime?
You sure might, yes.
Is it sweet?
From time to time.
Is it solid?
Yes.
Yes.
Would it be anything in the dessert family?
No.
Four down and six to go, Soupy.
And you're from Chicago?
Yes, I am.
I once saw a man dance with his wife in Chicago. On State Street, that great street.
Mm-hmm.
I just want you to know. Now, is this something that is in either the cucumber or pickle family?
Yes.
Yes, it is.
Well, she said sometimes it's sweet, sometimes it isn't. Sometimes I'm happy, sometimes... Mm-hmm. Would you be Miss Pickle?
Miss Pickle!
Yeah. Thank you.
Cindy is the current Miss Pulchritudinous Pickle.
Miss what?
Miss Pulchritudinous Pickle.
We should get that.
And she just reigned at the 82nd annual Pickle Packers International Convention. Where did they get that title?
Pickle
well,
packers.
They were really tired of having Miss Sourpuss and some of the other titles that they had, so they decided to have a pretty pickle for a change.
And so they called it Miss Pulchritudinous Pickle.
That's right.
What does pulchritudinous mean for those who don't know?
It means physically pretty or attractive, I
imagine. I'll certainly drink to that, folks. What else did you get along with your obviously deserved pulchritudinous title?
Oh, I got a $500 gift certificate and a pickle crown.
A pickle crown?
Yeah.
Could you show us your pickle crown?
Oh, I'd be happy to. Want to try that?
No. But it's lovely on you, and you've got to be as pretty as you are to get away with it. Thank you for being with us all. We'll be back with more of What's My Line after this message.
All What's My Line contestants receive these gifts. Sarah Coventry's unusual pin pendant called Imperial, with its turquoise color center stone with pearls and rhinestones and rings to match, by Sarah Coventry. And an assortment from Turtle Wax, the car care experts, featuring the Turtle Wax self-polishing paste wax kit with a professionally designed applicator. And Vanda Beauty products. Your phone book lists your Vanda Beauty counselor, who comes counseling to help you select your own personalized beauty program. Now back to Larry Blyton.
Okay, we're back, and it's time for our next challenger to enter. And sign in, please. Bob Dan Canix.
Is that right?
Where are you from?
Lebanon, New Jersey.
Lebanon, New Jersey. Panel, Robert Dan Canix is a psychotherapist turned craftsman. He makes a product which sells for as much as $4,000. We'll show our audience just what the product is. And let's begin with Arlene Francis.
Thank you. Is this product one that anybody might have in his or her home?
Yes.
Is it decorative?
No.
Just one down useful.
It's hard to say. It's attractive, this thing that he has, but whether or not it's not really used to decorate your house in that sense. One down, nine to go,
Soupy.
I didn't
mean in that sense, sweetheart.
It doesn't decorate your house, and it costs $4,000.
It
can cost $4,000. Is it in any kind of a way, Bob, is it anything in the recreation line?
Yes, it is.
Could it be found, it would have to be found, is it bigger than a bread box?
Most of the time, yes.
Yeah. Are there, other than this thing, is there other things used with it?
Yes.
Are there ever balls used with it?
Balls? No. Two down, eight to go, Anita.
Is it a game of some sort?
What he makes, is it a game? Wow, is that hard? Not really.
It's not a game.
It's not really a game.
So I get a no?
I don't think.
Gee whiz, Larry.
I tell you what, you get a no on one more question.
Okay. But is it, but it is a recreational thing. When you use this thing, does a person use it alone?
Not necessarily.
Three down, seven to go, Henry.
Is it in any way, does it,
how would you say this if you spoke English? All right, I'll try this way. Does it come to you, if I buy one of these things, do I get to manipulate it when I get home?
Yes.
Now, I wonder why I ask that.
Is it in any way a puzzle?
No.
Four down and six to go, Arlene.
Oh, it isn't any. So you can rule out that it's an erector set of any kind that you can build things out of, huh?
Yes.
But when you manipulate it, can it change its form in any way?
No.
Five down and five to go, Soupy.
Is there ever, Bob, any heat involved in this?
No.
Six down and four to go, Anita. There are things about it which can be manipulated. Let me clarify what you said, Arlene, because I've been sitting over here thinking about it. While it can be manipulated, the content can be manipulated, but not the general form. Uh-huh. Okay? Anita?
Well, I'm thoroughly confused by that. The contents can be manipulated, but not the general form.
Right.
Is it, is it a recreational thing? Is it one of those kind of things you use to, to pass the time away, like those, you know, those games that you, that make, that move, those things that move, that you watch, you know, like
yes, I
executives
know what you mean.
Have on their
it's
desks.
Not like that.
It's
seven
not
down,
that
three
kind
to go,
of...
Henry.
Do you need any skill with this thing?
No.
Eight down and two to go,
I wouldn't give you $4,000 for it, I'll tell you that.
Can I rule out that it's any kind of a bar?
Yes.
Pardon?
Yes, a bar. Yeah.
Do you put things onto this? Is it, when you look at it, could you think of it as maybe a kind of a piece of furniture?
In a way, you could, Arlene, if you really want to stretch it.
Can you stretch it? No. is it the things that you manipulate, are they extra things from the outside rather than legs or parts of the thing itself? For example, in a bridge table, you'd have to move the legs to get it to stand up. Partly both, huh?
Yeah, partly extraneous items and partly
I see.
The
and
thing
and
itself.
Partly the thing
is that
itself.
Right?
Yes, yes. Uh-huh.
Is this a kind of recreation that any of us on the panel might have enjoyed?
Yes.
Almost certainly.
Certainly, huh?
In fact,
what have
you.
I enjoyed that moves around? Let me think. Is it in any way connected with, not pachinko, but, you know, the things that add up scores and so forth?
Nothing like it.
Could we have a 10-second conference?
Yeah, try to figure out who uses it.
During the conference, I could answer
Arlie's
question.
Who uses it is the
we
clue.
We didn't ask who
children,
uses
probably.
It.
It's probably some kind of a playpen or...
Oh,
can I answer your thing about something you enjoy that moves around?
Yeah, what?
American Airlines.
is it something that, I got the last question, is it anything that you can lay on or sit on or sleep on?
Not an avoid catastrophe. Ladies, they are dolls' houses. Robert Dan Caddick is owner of the Dollhouse Factory, and there is no reason for us to sit here and talk about dollhouses when we can see them. So
that's
let's go up
I
and
see.
Have a look, shall we?
That was dumb.
It was
dumb.
Really dumb.
Thank you, Jennifer.
Now, what do we have here?
This is a beach house that has over 3,000 hand-split miniature cedar shakes. I'll open it up for you.
Oh, isn't that enchanting?
Have you got the inside of that? Is there, can you open up the monitor there so we can see it? Because I can't really tell what's on until we see it. That's really marvelous. All of that furniture was made to go in it, or did you buy it ready-made to go in it?
Both ways. Some was made and others is commercially available. This house, by the way, is an exact replica of a collector's beach house.
And a
collector's beach house.
A collector of what?
Of miniatures and dollhouses, yes.
Where is this house?
The house resides where the large house is in New Jersey, Barnegat, New Jersey.
Now, how much would this dollhouse be?
This dollhouse was $1,000.
Now, how about the furniture in it? How is this all to some kind of scale, or?
Yes, this is 1 inch to the foot scale. The furniture is rather simple. The value of all of it would probably be, probably under $300.
Let's just turn it around so everybody can see. That's the back of it, I guess, huh?
Yes.
Or at least the side.
Got no porch furniture.
And well, once they bought the dollhouse, they didn't have enough money to, after they furnished the inside, to go for it. Okay, now let's see the next one. Let's push this one off toward your side. And Jennifer will help us with this one. Oh, look at this one. This is a little more city-fied, this house, right?
Yeah, this is a colonial, rather classic salt box, and this one opens from the front.
Look at that. Now let's... That's a bedroom there. There's a hall. There's the bedroom.
The living room, and then a pretty formal dining room.
But some of this furniture in here is really kind of spectacular.
Yes, there's one piece in particular. This lowboy is an exact copy of a museum piece, and its value is $500. Even the pull of the drawer is turned on a jeweler's lathe.
Okay, that's a Duncan Fife, isn't it, Ernie?
Yes. This house even has an attic, by the way.
Oh, look at that. And it has a John upstairs. Boy, you're in a lot of trouble if you get in trouble down here and have to get up there.
Well, then we'll move it.
That's terrific. It can all be moved around. Isn't that terrific? I'll put this valuable piece back in here before we...
Thank you.
...do something rude to it. That's really beautiful. Look at that. It almost makes you wish you were young enough to do this and interested in doing it when you were young enough. Let's have the next one, can we? This one is some building over here. Okay, Jen. Now, what is this?
This is a Victorian mansion, which, well, we can show the inside. Has a door buzzer.
Yeah.
Okay, are these real bricks?
These are real bricks made of the same material that large bricks are made, fired to the same degree. We go far out for authenticity.
Well, here's a, well, I think this has been added on to the original house.
No, that came
after
with
the house was built. The people put on
it's
this.
It's not done yet.
Oh, it's not?
I had to rush it for the show.
Oh, it's not finished?
No.
I see.
It gets glass doors on the back yet and some dormers.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, let's start up here, Lloyd, can we? We're up in the attic again, I guess, are we not? In this dormer. Or this mansard roof light. Hmm?
That has a trap door, by the way, which works.
Can
by
you see
a
it?
Chain.
Can you see the.
I'm going to pull the chain, and the trap door goes up.
Can you see it, Lloyd? Have you got a shot of it?
Oh.
Now, this also has a john up here, and this is a playroom.
Right.
Hmm?
And then this is the child's bedroom right here with Victorian furniture.
That's that rotten rich kid that gets to go up there and play, right? And then this is the hall.
The hall, and then the master bedroom.
I see.
And does it have a dollhouse inside the dollhouse?
Then you come down here. This is the living room, right?
Here's the dollhouse for the dollhouse.
That is a dollhouse in the dollhouse. It's just what you said. Here's the living room. Now, how about this rug? Is that a real needle?
Yes, that's a real needlepoint, authentic Oriental pattern.
And then over here is the dining room.
Dining room with a kitchen in the front,
yeah.
And then a family room. This house, by the way, is totally lighted.
Can you see that those chandeliers are going out? Can you see that? Have you got a shine light?
There's even a fire in the fireplace if you look closely.
Really?
There is. The red flame.
Can we turn this around this way a little bit? Maybe they can get a shot of that. Can you see back in here? There's a little fire in. What is the cost of this house?
This is $1,500.
As soon as the recession is over, let's talk. Thank you for being with us on What's My Line. They're really terrific.
We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message.
Ah, we are back. And it is time now for the special feature of What's My Line, the appearance of our mystery guest. Are your blindfolds all in place,
they
panel?
They certainly are.
Have they been there a long time?
They certainly are.
Okay, then would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Okay, panel, we go one question at a time. Fate's law prevails. You have 2 minutes. And let's begin with Anita Gillette.
Thank you, Larry. Sir or madam, are you best known for your work in theater?
Yes, I am.
Henry?
Are you known as a dramatic artist?
Sometimes. Yes, I can be, but not in general, no.
Arlene?
It's a great voice.
It's marvelous, even for Donald Duck. Are you a cartoon character?
No.
Soupy?
Well, we haven't even found it. Is it a lady?
Yes, it is.
Anita.
Are you appearing in a play or musical at the time being?
In my own house, but not in a theater, no.
Henry?
What time do you go on?
All day long.
Have you done much television?
Yes, I have.
Arlene?
With that glorious voice, do you sing?
Yes, I do.
Soupy?
Absolutely
great,
fearless.
Great voice. Have you been on the Broadway theater in the last 6 months?
No.
Anita,
it's
almost in and out, you might say.
Oh, I want to take a guess, but I'm scared. Have I been to your house for dinner?
Are you kidding? No, you haven't, but I'd love for you to come.
Oh, Arlene? That's not who I'm thinking of.
Have you been on this show before?
Yes, I have.
Arlene?
Have you been a member of the panel?
No.
Snoopy?
Are you a blonde, short-haired lady?
I wanted to be, but I'm not. No, I'm not.
Anita?
I can't.
I don't think anybody's near it. I tell
Wait
you, these the voices have been so sensitive. This is Chita Rivera.
No!
I don't think anybody's near it. They were near. They didn't come close.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Oh, Soupy, I thought you were going to say it was Carol Lawrence again.
That was sensational.
Thank you. I like doing voices.
You've one of a group who have been in and out of rehearsal for a show like no show has ever been before.
Oh, yeah. Chicago.
No. Oh, yeah.
Starring Gwen and Jerry Orbach and myself. And it's so exciting. And Bobby Fosse was ill and needed desperately a rest, and God works in strange ways, but he makes himself very clear, and so Bobby had to rest. Yeah. So thank God he's much better now, and we start rehearsals very soon.
Terrific.
Well, are you going about a month, isn't it?
Yeah.
I don't know when the show's going to be shown, but it's about a month from now, I know.
Yeah.
Now, what are you playing in it?
We're all killers. I mean, all the ladies in the play are in prison, and they have killed someone. I've killed two people. I've killed my my manager and my sister. It's really, I mean, it's a musical, folks. I mean, it's a lot of laughs.
And you play a musical instrument in it, too?
Yes, I play the drums.
I was told, well, I'll tell
and
you
Gwen
about
And Gwen plays the sax. It's the funniest thing I've ever seen in your life.
I can't wait to see Gwen play the sax, and you play the drums, and Chicago goes back into rehearsal pretty soon. It's going to come. It's going to be a huge hit. I know it.
Please, God, yeah.
Good luck with it.
Thank you, Larry.
Well, I'll see you before.
Yes.
All right.
Oh, yes. Needle pointer.
All right. Good luck. Yeah. We'll be back with more of What's My Line after this message. We're really late, so we got to say goodbye and see Chita again. Goodbye, everybody.
This is Chet Gould speaking for What's My Line? A Mark Goodson, Bill Tompkins production. Miss Frances Gowns by Mark Rotella. This program was recorded.
Watching you little rascals.
Oh, it's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on. Push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube?
You.
Tube.
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 TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's gonna be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on.
Push the button.
Please.